भारत बनाने के लिए एजुकेशन पॉलिसी जो लिया है इसको फुलफिल किया जाए। धन्यवाद। थैंक यू।
धन्यवाद। माननीय सदस्य प्रियंका जरकोली।
सर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक द पीपल ऑफ माय कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी चिक्कोड़ी फॉर इलेक्टिंग मी एज देयर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव। फर्स्टली आई वुड लाइक टू कोट डॉक्टर बाबा साहब अम्बेडकर जी इज कोट एज ही फॉट अ केस इन चिक्कोड़ी कोर्ट। सो इट्स अ इमेंस प्राइड फॉर मी टू कम फ्रॉम दैट कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी। Sir, I would like to quote, the progress of any society depends on the progress of education in that society. But in the recent times in our country, the nation is facing a lot of issues in the education sector. Currently, our nation is facing challenges regarding to the quality, accessibility and equity in the education. Since 2014, the annual budget for the Ministry of Education has been steadily declining. This budget decreased funding for school education of 16.8% from the revised estimates and 7% overall for the Ministry of Education. The UGC's budget has been decreased by a staggering 53.35% compared to the budget estimates of 23-24 and 60.98% compared to the revised estimates of the previous fiscal year. This comes at a time when the National Testing Agency, an autonomous body under the UGC, is failing to properly conduct national examinations like NEET and NET, putting the future of lakhs of students at risk. In the past 7 years, the country has been witnessing 70 examination leaks across 15 states, affecting approximately 1.7 crore aspirants. Sir, and regarding my constituency, I would like to ask the minister through you, there's a Kendriya Vidyalay in the Athni and plus Gokak. The proposal for them has been sent but has not been approved. So I request the minister through you to sanction them as soon as possible. And sir, currently there has been a flood situation in my parliamentary constituency. Most of the schools and the buildings have been in a very deteriorating state. So through you, I would request the minister to revise the format for 10.2, which they provide 2 lakhs per school for the renovation and all, which has been not sanctioned at all due to the flood loss. And also, I would like to ask the government, as there are many students in my parliamentary constituency of SC, ST and OBC, whether there has been a lot of privatization in the education sector. So what steps the government has been taking to make sure that the rural background people will be able to access reasonable education in today's time? So I would like to know the answer for that, sir. Yes, sir, thank you for allowing me to speak. Thank you once again.